To whom this may concern. This is Stanley, Stanley J. Beaufort. I'm writing this letter to absolve myself of sin so that in death I can endure an ecstatic sense of childlike impotence. Forgive me, Father, for I have sinned. We are the clay and you our potter, but in recent I have been the potter and you my material. That's pretentious. 3 years ago exactly was the first and only time I took drugs. I tried mescaline at the age of 13. I attempted to reduce the complexity of the divine right into a comprehensible thought. This was not the case, as I promptly burned my great-grandfather's Bible that was written in German. My great-grandfather was an advisor to Hitler during World War II, but his family name was Bergman, which is why people tend not to derive any relation between us. Upon reconciling with the effects of the mescaline, I recognized that pattern and color occupied more of my concern than spatial relationships or having a will to exist. I found that it was no longer of value to try and sympathize with the mundane complacency of life. In fact, I would rather run through the street in a pair of white boxer shorts, suffocating myself with a plastic bag and a firework in my pants, than try to ask a friend of mine how their day was going. I would like to detail another profound moment of sin, when I killed an ex-girlfriend of mine because she attempted to condescend the size of my manhood. The story is as follows. I bought a train ticket to Westchester because she had moved out of the city. When I arrived, I attempted to confess my love, but she suspected my intentions would be to exploit her for money or for sex. I tried to tell her that our relationship was profound and that I would think about what life would be like if I had married her. She asked why we weren't married in the scenario, and I told her that it would be necessary for me to exercise caution as she could still run the risk of growing undesirable. She slapped me and told me that, quote, 2 inches was never enough, end quote. So I strangled her and documented the entire day in a series of photos I intended to make into a scrapbook but never did. To conclude this note, I wanted to address my family. One day, my mother had coerced me into visiting a local monument. She said it was symbolic of a Holocaust survivor, Anna Bergman, who had escaped Auschwitz with the help of a high-ranking Nazi officer. Anna Bergman was the youngest sister of one of Hitler's highest-ranking advisors, Gunther Bergman, my great-grandfather. While I don't believe I sinned over the course of this last anecdote, Father, it was the conversation with my mother after visiting the statue that justified my choosing to neglect them in this letter.
I thought it was very profound. It's another deliberate symbol of female empowerment.
I thought that the history of it was more fascinating.
But don't you think it's time for change?
I don't think that exercising power will necessarily contribute to equality, if that's what you're saying.
You know,
in rewriting this conversation, I realized my family were all individual contrasts of God, and that my life has merely been a series of contradictions. I will no longer prevent myself from achieving the absurdly impossible. Yours truly, Stanley. Peace.